Bonjour à tous. Merci d'avoir accepté l'invitation et d'être présent aujourd'hui alors que la LECB, la Ville de Montréal et l'arrondissement de Verdun se réunissent pour faire une annonce importante. Avant d'aller plus loin, j'aimerais vous présenter nos invités d'honneur et souligner leur présence. Consultant de la LECB depuis les tout débuts, M. Mark Waitman, et directeur général de Basketball Québec, M. Daniel Grimard, sont avec nous. Merci. Et nos invités qui participeront à la conférence de presse, M. Mike Morreale, PDG commissaire de la Ligue élite canadienne de basketball, Mme la mairesse Valérie Plante, M. le maire de l'arrondissement Verdun, Jean-François Parenteau, et la vice-présidente opération de l'équipe de Montréal, Annie Larouche. Notre premier invité est le commissaire et PDG de la Ligue élite canadienne de basketball. Son leadership à l'égard de la LECB découle de sa vaste expérience en tant que joueur de la Ligue canadienne de football et a reçu plusieurs honneurs. Représentant de l'Association des joueurs de la LCF, diffuseur, leader communautaire et dirigeant d'entreprises prospères. Sous sa direction, la LECB s'est établie comme l'une des meilleures ligues de basketball professionnel au monde et peut-être même la ligue la plus innovante de tous les sports. Mike a contribué au développement de la LECB, qui est passée de 6 franchises à ses débuts à 9 équipes aujourd'hui, et le meilleur reste à venir. Joignez-vous à moi pour souhaiter la bienvenue à Mike Morreale. Without further ado, please welcome the Commissioner and CEO of the CEBL, Mr. Mike Morreale.
I have to raise this a bit, sorry.
Merci beaucoup. Bonjour à tous et merci de votre présence aujourd'hui. Je suis bien content d'être à Montréal pour cette grande annonce.
Welcome to all of you. That's the extent of my French at this point in time. I will continue to work on it. Welcome to Mayor Plante, Mayor Parenteau, and everyone in attendance today. We're very excited that you're all here. We're very excited to announce our 9th franchise in the CBL and our largest market, the Montreal market. We're incredibly excited. And without further ado, we'll roll the video and find out what this team is named, and I'll be right back up here to continue after that. And there we have it. I'm very pleased to welcome the Montreal Alliance as our 9th team in the CBL, and it's been just an incredible journey to get to this point, and I'd like to recognize a few people here in attendance. Certainly Julie Mahoney, who is here, has been tremendous in helping bridge the gap between both the city of Montreal and Verdun, the borough of Verdun, and all the staff in helping us get to this point to play in such a great venue. Beside me, the new refurbished Verdun Auditorium and their tremendous history of entertainment and sports that have taken place right next to me on my left. There's another couple people I want to congratulate. Annie LaRouche. Annie is now, as of right now, has become the Vice President of Operations for the Montreal Alliance, moving on from her Director of CBL for our Montreal franchise. And Annie, congratulations. We're very excited to have you on board. And we go back a heck of a long way, along with this next gentleman who I'd like to make mention of, because going back probably 3 to 4 years ago, we had a conversation about the Montreal market, about the CBL, and the potential of bringing a team here, and that is Mark Waitman. So thank you, Mark. He's been a special advisor to me personally into league office and has done just an incredible amount of work to get here, and combined with the amount of work he's done in sport in Quebec and in Montreal in general. So thanks again, Mark, for you being here today. When we talk about Montreal, it's very important to kind of talk about the CBL in general and where we are, where we want to be. The CBL is the official league of Canada. As our relationship with Canada Basketball, that was one of the first things we did before we created this league, was to sit down and make sure that we looked at things and teams and leagues that have come and gone in the past in the basketball space in this country, and to make sure we didn't fall into those same, I guess, troubling times, and find a way to work ourselves to a point where we can create a league and create teams that can be stable and last and take advantage of the great evolution of basketball in this country. And when you speak about the evolution of basketball and trajectory that this game is on, there are a handful of people here, men and women, that have played on the national team, that have played at high level professional basketball, that are really helping us get to this point and really became the stepping stones to allow us to be here. And I hope that you'll continue to be great supporters of the Montreal Alliance and the CBL as we move forward. We're excited about the entertainment we bring. We're excited about the quality of basketball we bring. It is no doubt that outside of the NBA Toronto Raptors, this is the best basketball you will see in this entire country. We have just graduated three or four players to the NBA from last year. We're regularly playing with G League players, high level international players overseas, our top Canadian talent that's not in the NBA or not in major international divisions. And we've created an opportunity to celebrate our basketball people and all the accomplishments that they've made and all the hard work that they have gone through to get to this point. We're now creating a landscape in Canada, and specifically in this market in Quebec, to be able to attract back some of our best players and our best coaches and our best GMs and our best basketball people. And I will tell you in short order, we will have an announcement on the GM of this team, and you will be equally impressed with the people that we are going to bring in to help run this team. The Montreal market has a long history of basketball, of very good basketball, graduating players to the NBA, graduating players to high level overseas, and more importantly, they continue to do that and excel at the grassroots and developmental level. I would say that, you know, maybe not too long ago, the Quebec market trailed some of the bigger markets like BC and Ontario. I'm not sure that's the case anymore. I would suggest that Quebec is probably leading the way in the development of the next level basketball players, men and women. And we're really excited to bring professional basketball to the Montreal market. When we look at the name and we look at the logo, we always try to find ways to tie what we do to the community. You will see the color scheme obviously is representative of a few teams that have graced this market and continue to be here. So we're very excited about, you know, keeping in those color tones. The wolf that you see is indigenous and native to Quebec. It runs in packs. It forms alliances, it works together to hunt its prey, no different than teams or leagues that get together to win games. And when you talk about the alliance in general, I can speak to countless things of how we all had to come together to get to this point, through the city of Montreal, through the borough, through the people that have helped make this work. And we're really just incredibly excited for all of you to become an ally, to join the alliance and be part of this great CBL team going forward. With that, I want to thank you all very much, and I really look forward to May 25th, when our CBL season will start, our fourth year, and it'll be taking place right next door, and I'm sure you're going to have an incredible time being part of what we're going to produce here. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Mike. Veuillez maintenant accueillir la mairesse de Montréal, Mme Valérie Plante.
Merci beaucoup. Quel plaisir d'être avec vous aujourd'hui ici dans l'arrondissement de Verdun. Je salue d'ailleurs mon collègue Jean-François Parenteau. Monsieur Montréalais, bienvenue. Bienvenue à Montréal et j'espère que vous allez nous voir souvent. Hopefully, maybe the first game we can sit together and watch the game here in Verdun. Et Madame Larouche, qui est la directrice des opérations pour l'Alliance de Montréal. Je ne vous cacherai pas que c'est très agréable de voir une femme à la tête de l'Alliance comme ça. Bien sûr, c'est une équipe, mais il n'en demeure pas moins que c'est une... Je vous félicite, vraiment. Écoutez, c'est indéniable que le basketball est dans le cœur des Montréalais puis que ça prend toujours plus d'importance et c'est toujours de plus en plus populaire. Après ça, en 2019, quand tout le monde s'est mis à suivre ce qui se passait à Toronto avec les Raptors, et qu'on a vu leur ascension, bien, j'ai envie de vous dire que c'est la seule et unique fois où on a vu Montréal être sur le même bord que Toronto. Mais là, une fois, là maintenant, c'est à notre tour. Alors, on va avoir une équipe ici, chez nous, à Montréal. C'est une nouvelle extraordinaire. Et je tiens vraiment à remercier la Ligue canadienne de basketball d'avoir dit, OK, maintenant, c'est à Montréal que ça se passe. L'Alliance de Montréal, je trouve que ça nous tient comme un gant. Et je sais à quel point il va y avoir beaucoup de jeunes, de moins jeunes. Les fans vont venir à Montréal pour voir jouer des athlètes incroyables de haut calibre ici à Verdun. Et ça, je tiens à le mentionner, c'est quand même exceptionnel de voir ce sport qui vient s'implanter dans le quartier. Verdun, qui est un quartier en pleine expansion, qui est reconnu partout à travers le monde. On utilise une infrastructure déjà existante pour installer un autre sport. C'est ce que je trouve que c'est la beauté du basketball qui est facile, somme toute, à pouvoir... on peut le mettre en... C'est complémentaire à d'autres sports qui sont pratiqués dans une installation comme l'Aréna de Verdun. Et en plus, bien, on va pouvoir venir même en métro. On va pouvoir, après ça, pourquoi pas aller faire un petit plongeon à la plage de Verdun, aller visiter les artères commerciales tout autour. Fait que ce que j'ai envie de vous dire, c'est « This is a great gift for Montreal and for the borough because people will come here, they will enjoy a game and then they will just, you know, enjoy the commercial street, go to the restaurant and take a swim in the water. » Alors, je trouve que c'est un ajout vraiment important pour Montréal. Finalement, permettez-moi de dire que quand on a des joueurs comme Lugansdor ou encore Cambridge, dont j'ai eu la chance de rencontrer la maman il n'y a pas si longtemps, ou encore Chris Boucher, ce sont des modèles montréalais. C'est des jeunes bien de chez nous qui nous font rayonner, qui sont des sources d'inspiration. Et moi, je vois l'arrivée d'une équipe, ici à Montréal, une équipe de basketball, comme une opportunité supplémentaire de valoriser le sport, de faire en sorte que nos jeunes pratiquent des activités qui leur plaisent, qui leur permettent non seulement d'acquérir des aptitudes qui les amènent jusqu'à une ligue nationale, évidemment, mais aussi de pouvoir retisser les communautés. Le sport est un incroyable outil pour rapprocher les communautés. Alors, very proud to be here. Je suis vraiment très contente et puis j'ai bien hâte de venir voir un match de l'Alliance de Montréal en prenant le métro. Puis je pense qu'après ça, on va aller faire un plongeon dans l'eau, Monsieur le maire. Merci beaucoup. Bonne journée.
Merci. Veuillez maintenant accueillir le maire de l'arrondissement Verdun, M. Jean-François Parenteau.
Alors, bonjour tout le monde. Première chose que j'aimerais dire, c'est Mike, Annie, welcome home. Parce qu'il y a beaucoup de travail derrière cette annonce aujourd'hui. On est parti de loin, apprivoiser la Ligue, travailler. Ça fait un an, tantôt, Mike le dit, Julie, au niveau des sports, loisirs, culture, ou que le travail de longue haleine. Il y a Marie-André Mauger, qui est ici aussi conseillère municipale. L'ensemble du conseil a travaillé très fort pour faire avancer, discuter, faire évoluer le projet. Mais c'était tellement important pour nous, tellement important parce qu'on venait de sortir d'un projet de rénovation majeure de l'auditorium de Verdun. Puis on devait, au-delà du bâtiment, on devait le meubler, ce bâtiment. Le meubler avec des valeurs qui nous est propres, qui nous est chères. C'est d'avoir du sport, une tradition de sport à Verdun, mais une tradition de sport populaire et accessible à la population. On a déjà le Centre d'excellence de hockey féminin où on est très, très fiers de cette entente. Et cette autre étape importante avec du sport professionnel, mais accessible, où on va remplir les estrades parce que les jeunes vont venir s'inspirer de joueurs talentueux et pouvoir développer l'attachement au sport et la pratique du sport. On peut très bien imaginer dans quelques années l'impact qu'aura l'Alliance de basketball sur la jeunesse montréalaise dans les prochaines années. Des vedettes, des grandes stars du basketball, on n'a pas fini d'en avoir provenant de Montréal. Alors, pour nous, c'était très, très, très important. Alors, aujourd'hui, c'est un grand jour. J'ai très hâte de voir évoluer cette alliance entre Montréal et l'équipe de basketball. Et le nom de l'alliance, on en a discuté beaucoup. C'est un nom qui est quand même très porteur parce que ça parle beaucoup. Et c'est l'alliance entre une communauté, c'est l'alliance d'un sport avec un milieu de vie. Et c'est l'alliance, et une nouvelle tradition pour Montréal. Le sport, ça va dépasser, je dirais, parce que la jeunesse est très attachée comme sport en progression. Le basketball, la jeunesse y est très attachée. Et je suis certain que ça va être très, très, très populaire. Alors, merci beaucoup. Bonne fin de journée. Et au plaisir de vous rencontrer pour le premier match. Et surtout, allez tous aller se baigner après dans la plage de Verdun.
Merci beaucoup. Veuillez maintenant accueillir la vice-présidente de l'Alliance de Montréal, Mme Annie Larouche.
Et mon Dieu, je vais lire parce que ceux qui me connaissent bien savent que je pourrais partir pour une demi-heure. Donc, soyez patients avec moi. Madame la mairesse, Monsieur le maire, merci. Mike, thank you. Mark, conseiller senior pour la Ligue, grand ami, mentor dans tout ça, M. Grimard de la Fédération de basketball du Québec et distingués invités, merci à vous tous d'avoir rendu ce projet possible. C'est avec une grande fierté que je représente la nouvelle équipe de basketball professionnelle de la LECB, l'Alliance de Montréal. D'ailleurs, je tiens à remercier les 1500 personnes qui ont répondu au sondage. Vous avez été très créatifs, inspirants. Et je vais dire félicitations à Alexis, Isabelle et Nadia qui nous ont suggéré le nom Alliance. Je vous raconterai un jour l'histoire de ma coiffeuse. Montréal est une mosaïque de plus de 120 communautés culturelles qui embrassent l'individualité, la diversité, l'inclusion, et c'était pour nous le nom parfait. My basketball friends, la communauté basketball, merci de votre accueil et de votre confiance. Vous auriez pu dire, mais qu'est-ce qu'une fille de foot vient faire au basket? Peut-être que vous vous l'êtes dit, vous ne me l'avez pas laissé savoir, mais je vous remercie de votre accueil. On a eu de belles discussions ensemble. Vous m'avez donné votre opinion, vos idées, et ce n'est que le début d'une belle collaboration. Le basketball, on l'a mentionné, est en pleine croissance au Québec, et bien sûr, c'est grâce à nos Québécois qui ont percé dans la NBA, mais aussi à des joueurs comme Alain Louis, Nervens Demosthène, Guillaume Boucard, Kémy Ossé, qui jouent pour notre ligue et qui font rayer le talent local. Et on le sait, du talent local, on en a, et on a très hâte de donner l'opportunité à nos Québécois de pouvoir jouer chez eux, devant leur famille et amis. Ce succès et cette croissance, c'est surtout grâce à vous, communauté basketball, entraîneurs, parents, bénévoles, qui êtes les pionniers et qui partagez votre passion avec nos jeunes et qui les faites grandir. C'est grâce aussi au côté visionnaire de notre commissaire, Mike Morreale, et des dirigeants de la Ligue. C'est bien sûr grâce aux partisans qui déjà démontrent un grand intérêt pour la Ligue, mais aussi pour notre équipe, l'Alliance. Nous sommes emballés d'élire domicile ici, à l'Auditorium de Verdun, le plus ancien aréna de Montréal, et c'est situé dans le 11e quartier le plus cool au monde. Quand même, selon Time Out Magazine. Merci à tous ceux dans l'arrondissement. On l'a répété souvent, ça fait longtemps qu'on négocie, mais qui ont travaillé dans l'ombre et qui ont donné vie à ce projet. Et pour ne nommer que ceux-là, je vais nommer Marlène Gagnon, Julie Mahoney, Alexandre Varin et Carl Néron. Merci. Oui. Merci aux élus qui croient au projet et à l'impact positif que cette équipe peut avoir sur la communauté, que ce soit un impact social avec les différents programmes communautaires que nous mettrons de l'avant, ou encore un impact économique avec les partenariats d'affaires que nous établirons avec les entreprises locales. I am pleased to represent this new CBL franchise in Montreal, and I am proud of the work we have accomplished this far to create an identity true to Montreal's community. I am thrilled to think that a professional basketball team in Montreal will become a source of inspiration for our youth. J'aimerais terminer en vous disant que je suis très heureuse d'être ici, mais que j'ai encore plus hâte de vous retrouver ici, de l'autre côté des fenêtres, alors que vous porterez les couleurs de notre équipe et que vous encouragerez nos joueurs. Merci.
Alors, merci à nos invités. Il y aura maintenant une période de questions. On vous demande de vous présenter à Morane, qui a le micro, et de vous identifier.
Benoît Rioux de l'agence QMI, une question pour Annie. Évidemment, il y a un passé de basket à Montréal. Il y a une réalité aussi qui a toujours été présente à Montréal concernant les clubs professionnels qui ne sont pas dans des ligues majeures. Puis j'aimerais savoir c'est quoi les stratégies puis, qui va dire à tout le monde, cette fois-ci, ça va marcher, ce club-là, qui n'est pas un club de la NBA, mais un club de basket dans une ligue plus mineure. Qu'est-ce qui te fait dire, cette fois-ci, ça va marcher?
Bien, en fait, je vais dire que c'est la plus grande ligue de basketball au Canada. Donc, évidemment, pour moi, c'est pas une ligue mineure. Je pense que la LECB, la Ligue élite canadienne de basketball, a fait ses preuves les trois dernières années. C'est la seule ligue qui a joué en pandémie après seulement 2 ans d'existence. Donc, la structure est bonne, la base, elle est bonne et je suis très, très, très confiante.
Est-ce qu'on a d'autres questions?
Good afternoon. Josh Grant with CBC. I'm just curious how it's going to work here. We see two arenas. How is this going to be converted into a gym?
I'll answer this question. Well, on this side, the Scotty Bowman ice will be converted into a basketball court for the months of May through August.
Thank you. Just to add to that, and maybe it's my time to say a few things about basketball in this country and where we're heading. Right now, we play in major spectator facilities all across the country. Generally, those are hockey arenas. One day, we hope to play in purpose-built basketball facilities across the country and to, really take advantage of the trajectory that basketball is on. But this beautiful arena beside us will convert and it will look intimate and excellent, and it'll create a fan environment that we're going to be very proud of.
Tell me what this means to the city of Montreal, to people playing basketball, whether it's at Concordia, at McGill, whether it's at Champlain, Dawson College, there's all these great basketball programs here, and now these players can look local if they want to go maybe to the next step. How much does that mean to the city and to basketball, as you said, in Canada?
I won't speak from the city's perspective, but I will speak to how we developed this league and why we developed this league. We put great emphasis on the showcasing of our great Canadian talent that has had to go overseas to play professional basketball because there wasn't an opportunity here at home. So we're very proud of that. But we're also equally proud, if not more proud, about the developmental side of what we do, both men and women, and grassroots development, and creating a pathway where people at Dawson's College or Cégep or University of Montreal, et cetera, can actually have a clear pathway to say, I can stay in Canada, remain in Canada, and have an opportunity to play professional basketball in my hometown or in my home country with their name on their back, just like I did as a young kid sitting at Iverwind Stadium, looking at the CFL players that I adored. That's what we're trying to replicate here in basketball.
Well, I definitely want to build on what Mr. Morielli just said. So not only is it amazing for students and citizens here to continue their career in Montreal, that's great, but also from a city perspective, having a professional team, having this entire ecosystem being stronger is also amazing. and it's good for the economy. Like I said, you might come for, you decide to come for a game, you take the metro, then after or before, you enjoy a meal, you enjoy the environment. And I think it's gonna bring a lot of momentum, a lot of energy to the sports scene in Montreal. That's a great add to what we have to offer.
Kubino Duro, CBC News. Hi, Mike. We've been talking about this since February, about bringing a team to Montreal, and now you're here in front of everyone. How does it feel to be here and see how it's being received in the city?
Well, this is incredibly fantastic. Obviously, we're in a major metropolitan area, and you can see by the amount of people here and the amount of cameras and the involvement of everyone that obviously we've struck a bit of a nerve in a good way, and we're very excited. It also brings with it more eyeballs and more pressure. But we have built this league to continue to grow and prosper and get bigger and bigger. And there's a reason why we have taken our time to come to Montreal, because we wanted to do it properly. And we'd love to follow this with a Quebec City team. And we want to continue to grow this market because it can, you know, handle and accommodate easily what we're doing. But most importantly, you know, this will become and is now our biggest market in terms of population and size, and obviously our biggest Francophone market. And we play a global game. And as much as we're excited, of course, about bringing not only our domestic teams here, our league teams here, we want to bring international games here and international opponents. And that's part of the whole progression of what we're doing. And we took our time, and I'm glad we did. And I'm really excited about the pathway we're on. I'm excited to tip the ball off here in not too distant future.
And I know in some of the other teams around the league, they have some basketball camps for like the young kids. Is there a plan to do that here in Montreal so we can get the young kids up and get them excited about playing basketball at the next level?
It's very important that Annie and her staff, they already know this, that they're going to integrate themselves into the local basketball community at all levels, and they're going to welcome those people at all levels. Basketball is one of the most accessible sports in the world. It's one of the most diverse sports in the world. It's long overdue to have it raised on a pedestal here in this country. And, I think there's a fan base that hasn't been heard for quite some time that is finally going to get heard. And we're going to work tooth and nail at the grassroots developmental level, at all levels, to make sure that we make them feel like this is their home as well.
Good afternoon, Gloria Enriquez with Global News. You say that Montreal has evolved into one of the strongest regions for basketball in the country. We do know that Montreal is a hockey-crazed nation, so how do you plan to compete with hockey?
Well, one of the good things is we don't play or overlap with hockey, number one, so we understand the power and influence of hockey. We also understand that basketball is in a trajectory unto itself, which my hope is one day surpasses hockey. And it goes in line with diversity and inclusion and accessibility and providing opportunities that maybe didn't exist before. We want to partner and feel like we're part of the team in the sports landscape here. We don't want to compete directly, just as much as I don't want to compete against the FC or compete against the Alouettes. I want to be able to, and Annie will lead the way on this, but we want to be able to show that we're all in this together. We want to be a strong domestic pro league. Right now, we would be in the same amount of teams as the CFL, and we would be only one of three true pro domestic leagues in this entire country. So we understand that brings with it a lot, and a lot of excitement, a lot of pressure to make sure that we continue to grow the game and influence young people, but also to get along with our teammates. And in this case, that's the other sporting groups, both professional and amateur.
And can you explain what do you mean by the conditions are right now, that Montreal is a strong basketball region?
Yeah, I mean, you just have to look at, a lot of us get, absorbed with players in the NBA, and certainly Quebec has been able to produce many of those over the recent years and in past years as well. But it goes further beyond that. I know in our league alone, we have over a dozen, both players and coaches and support staff, et cetera, that are Quebec-born, that are Quebec-schooled. In my history of sport, I've always been impressed with the support that Quebecois give to their own. And the backing they give, and the ability to train and get better and be the best in class. So I hope that that's adopted on the basketball side. We want to lead the way from a professional perspective, but we want to do it in conjunction with Canada Basketball, from the National Federation and all the local provincial federations to grow. But we see it in numbers. We see it in the amount of players that are graduating to the NCAA or to CJEP or to U Sport and to overseas leagues. And I think what some people don't understand quite yet is how big basketball is. It's just been a little bit in the shadows. So our goal is to bring it out of those shadows and really shine a spotlight on it.
And just again, I know that my colleague asked you in French, you know, we had the Montreal Jazz here. They only played for one season. So what makes it different this time?
I can list off quite a few differences. I'll start with some of the most important. One, the trajectory of basketball over the last 25 years has gone incredibly through the roof. And that's, you know, buoyed by the fact we've had two at one time NBA teams, although the Raptors have carried the torch. The players that play in our league for the most part are players that grew up in the Vince Carter era, who were enamored with what the Raptors were all about, and we seeing the results now. What we'll see out of the results of the Raptors winning the championship in 2019, the continued growth of the NBA players in the NBA, Canadian players in the NBA, is that the next 30, 40, 50 years will be massive for us. And you know, it's our job to create the platform to do that, and to work together with like-minded groups that want to help us get there. It's going to take a lot of hard work and a lot of support. And we like to do we don't speak unless there's something to say. And the next time you hear from us, it'll be a major announcement on the GM. The next time you hear from us, it'll be on the coach and on the players. And we'll continue to grow until we start to attract maybe some people that didn't think about basketball as their first thought. And I just encourage people to come for the party, stay for the game. It's kind of like we want to say, and it's more than just basketball.
Et bonjour à vous tous. Marc Defoy du Journal de Montréal. Madame Larouche, est-ce que l'organisation a fait des études de marché, à savoir, les fans de basketball, on parle de combien? On parle de combien de joueurs à Montréal et au Québec? On m'a déjà dit, mais ça n'a jamais été vérifié, que le basketball était peut-être le sport le plus pratiqué sur l'île de Montréal dans les écoles. Est-ce que vous pouvez nous situer un peu là-dessus?
Les chiffres que je vais vous donner, évidemment, proviennent de M. Grimard, de la Fédération de basketball du Québec. M. Grimard, vous me faites signe si je me trompe dans mes chiffres, mais je pense qu'on a 55 000 membres à la Fédération, donc 45 sont des joueurs. Et puis, depuis les cinq dernières années, oui, effectivement, probablement avec le succès des Raptors, mais c'est exponentiel la croissance du basketball au Québec. Et oui, effectivement, dans les écoles.
Un détail qui me manque, l'équipe appartient à qui? Est-ce que ça appartient à la Ligue? Comment ça fonctionne?
Oui, en fait, c'est une Ligue à propriétaire unique pour 8 équipes, sauf l'équipe de Scarborough. Alors, c'est le même propriétaire pour les 8 autres équipes. Et c'est M. Morreale qui est le commissaire. Oui, les équipes appartiennent à un propriétaire unique.
just say it, I'll answer.
Yeah? So, c'est M. Richard Petko qui est propriétaire de la Ligue. Et des 8 équipes, encore une fois. Petko.
Yeah, I'm not the owner, although, I act like it sometimes. Yes, exactly. Well, I know. Yeah, just to clarify on that point, and to the point that the lady made as well, that I don't think I fully answered that some of the differences of why, this time over the last times. We took a very different approach to how we started this league. We started as a single entity ownership, which meant that the league owns all the teams. And we did that purposely to create a very high level of consistency and parity across the board in not just play, but in how we operate. And we designed it also to be sold to local groups piece by piece over time. Our first external partnership is the Scarborough team, like Annie mentioned. That ownership group is made up of some very big players in the sports and entertainment industry, OVO, Sam Ibrahim, and of course the connection through OVO to Drake. So we're excited about that. That certainly kicks the door open from an entertainment side. But we play a FIBA game. You know, it's a high energy, fast paced game. It's a lot of energy, it's got different rules. It's a game that helps train our players for the national team, that helps train for national competitions. We play with an Elam ending, which I won't get into that now. It might be a little confusing, but we're the only league in the world that does that. It's a different way to finish a game, a highly entertaining way to finish it. Every game ends on a bucket, on a made basket. And we're predominantly Canadian. We've taken the approach that we are going to be mandate that we are predominantly Canadian. And I think it's important to realize that our domestic talent are the imports overseas. They are the highly sought after players that go to play in Europe and Asia, et cetera, and are paid the most and are the one or two de facto international groups or international roster spots. We get to bring all of them back here and to share the court. And I think that's incredibly important, but none more important than when we play. Our timing, that spring and summer timing, allows us access to the best available players because the international basketball season is over. And it also, and certainly for this city, but for the country as well, Canada is a destination. And we know Montreal will be a destination, absolutely, for players and coaches and everyone. But Canada is a destination not only for Canadians, but for US-born players, international players, where they can come and play in high-level competition, be on national and international television, and really, you know, have a launching point to their next stage in their career.
Olivier Larue pour RDS. La mairesse a mentionné tout à l'heure les noms des trois Québécois là, qui sont présentement dans la NBA. À quel point est-ce que ça peut aider la nouvelle équipe à s'implanter à Montréal de voir ces joueurs-là sur la scène internationale?
En fait, que ça démontre qu'on a beaucoup de talent local. D'avoir trois joueurs et peut-être plus sous peu là, qui jouent dans la NBA, ça démontre qu'il y a du talent. Ça donne de l'espoir aussi à nos jeunes de dire, ben, tu sais quoi, moi aussi, peut-être qu'un jour, je vais jouer pour les grandes ligues, que ce soit dans la NBA ou même ici à Montréal, devant leur famille et leurs amis. C'est une plateforme supplémentaire pour faire rayonner le sport.
Puis, M. Montréalais parlait d'une annonce prochaine concernant un GM, un nouvel entraîneur. Est-ce qu'on a une idée du moment où ça pourrait survenir? Puis, comment se passent justement les discussions, la recherche de joueurs, d'entraîneurs et de GM?
En fait, on va commencer, on va suivre les étapes. Donc, on va commencer par le GM. Vous ne voulez pas que ce soit moi qui choisisse l'entraîneur et les joueurs, je peux vous l'assurer. Donc, les démarches vont bon train. Et puis, quelques semaines et on fera une autre annonce.
So the season runs approximately 3.5 months-ish.
What's the average salary like for players in the league, more or less?
So we have a range salary from $400 to $1,500 a game. So our average salary is close to $1,000 a game, which would put us on a per game basis higher than the G League. So that's really from comparison point of view, the G League would be probably our biggest comparable. The players in the G League, I think it just went up this year to $37,000 annually. They play 5 months, they play 50 games. The average salary is about $725. So that gives you an example.
So how many games, 20 to
20? 20 regular season games plus playoffs, yes. And then further to that, there's bonus opportunities within there outside of the regular game pay, and that doesn't include playoff pay, et cetera. So there's other opportunities for the players to earn income.
The thing that we've noticed in this city is, and especially with the times changing now, is that a lot of the teams that are not in the major league really struggle to get people's attention. I mean, we see it with soccer teams, see it with football team, the NFL, and European clubs, and I go to my soccer league on Sunday morning, nobody's talking about the CF Montreal game that they were playing. They're just talking about Juventus and Milan. So they really struggle to get the attention if they're not in that platform. What can you do in order to make sure that people start to care?
Yeah, that's a great question. I think it's important to realize who you are and where you're at and how you fit. I think we know exactly where we fit. We know we're not the NBA, but we know, again, to my point, we're the best basketball played. We're also played in a time and year where there is no basketball. So you're coming off, you know, NBA fans will come off an NBA season and roll into a CBL season. There's no direct competitive, you know, competition elsewhere that would draw their attention somewhere else. So, you know, all knowing who you are, understanding, and putting on a good show and having high quality basketball and having local people as part of it. You know, being able to say that I'm going to watch a game and I went to school with this guy or lived down the street or he went to the same cégep or university that I went to really speaks volumes to growing the community side. And everything we do is about the community. It really is about engaging our fans when they're here, but also providing opportunities for our players and our staff to get out into the community and to continue to grow that message and provide opportunities for people. So it's always a challenge when you're selling entertainment. And it's always a challenge to be compared to the next best thing. We know in this case, the next best thing in the all over the world is the NBA. So we just know kind of where we're at and we know when we play and we feel like when we get people into the arena, we can keep them here and we can get them coming back for more.
Alors, ceci termine la conférence de presse. Merci à tous de votre présence. Nos invités seront maintenant disponibles pour la prise de photos officielles et les entrevues individuelles. On vous invite à demeurer des nôtres. Les cocktails et les rafraîchissements vous sont offerts. Merci beaucoup. Bonne fin de journée.